Now for the senior race and a glimpse of Thursday's way in. Harold Daniel has his back to us. Reg Armstrong and Jeff Duke are with him. Bob McIntyre gets waylaid. And this is John Hartle's MV. Graham Walker with Bob Webster from Canada entered on a Norton. Number 54 is Harry Hinton. Jack Ahern has the experimental single-cylinder mashless. Surtees' machine is wheeled along by the MV mechanics, but John is busy farther back. And so to race day, with Castrol's George Williams carrying the can. Number 75 is Dickie Dale with his BMW. Number 42 is John Hartle. And 24, Bob McIntyre with the Joe Potts Norton. 56, Mickey O'Rourke. 72 is Jack Brett's Norton. Jeff Duke is number 20. This is Marcott from the United States with his 350 AJ, and he took home a bronze replica for the senior. It's time for the start, and number one is Roberton with a 350 Norton. Jeff Duke gets away. Bob McIntyre, number 24. There goes John Hartle and John Surtees, screaming off towards Bray Hill. Now to the famous bump at Balaff Bridge on this first lap, and it's almost impossible to read the numbers. Here comes Jeff Duke. Next, a shot of John Hartle. And you tell me who these three are, but the next man is Surtees. Cronk Namona, lap one, and Bob McIntyre's really steaming. He's already ahead of Jeff Duke, the second of these two, and does his first lap just 4 seconds slower than Surtees at 98.5 miles an hour. Now to lap three at Union Mills. McIntyre comes through, but he's in trouble. Slows, and in fact stops, just up the road. This Anderson, in fifth place at the moment, averaging over 95 miles an hour and on his way to a brilliant second place. John Hartle is in second place at the moment, his second lap completed at just over the ton, but round at Governor's Bridge is MV Cashire. Surtees on the way to a TT double, also had 100 miles an hour lap. Arthur Wheeler goes through. Lap 4, Braddon Bridge, Bob Anderson leading on the road, followed by Derek Minter. And these two are well up in the all-Norton dice for leaderboard positions behind Surtees. Surtees has just made a pit stop for fuel and streams through with a comfortable lead. Already many of the stars are out of the race. Jeff Duke, Jack Brett, Terry Shepherd, Bob McIntyre and John Hartle among them. John Surtees is firmly in command, but there's a terrific scrap going on for the next places. Alistair King has best part of a minute's advantage in second place, but 30 seconds only separate Bob Brown, Bill Holmes, Bob Anderson, Minter, Trow, Buchan and Campbell. John Surtees sweeps through Ginger Hall, halfway round on his fifth lap. Alan Trow there is in eighth place, but this fifth lap is the last one he completed. McGuffey from Canada streaks down Bray Hill, and we're waiting now for the leaders to start on their sixth lap. This is Bob Anderson, still leading on the road, and starting lap six in fourth place. Here comes Derek Minter, starting lap six in fifth place. Surtees hurtles down, nearly 5 minutes ahead of Alistair King. Here's Bob McIntyre on the long walk home from Union Mills. And now to Ramsey, the start of the climb to the hairpin, and the second rider here is Bob Brown in third place. This is Holmes, and Carby Rettertrouble on this lap dropped him from sixth place to 25th at the finish. The last of this trio is Palmer. And Alistair King, who had the cruel luck to drop the model on his last lap and so forfeit second place. At the end of the sixth lap, Surtees calls in for fuel, just to be on the safe side, as he put it. And in 18 seconds, he's off on his last lap, which for John was comparatively slow, at a mere 95 miles an hour. Back again to Ramsey, with the American Marcotte going away to the hairpin. John Surtees again, driving well within himself. The second of these two is Chadwick, on his way to fifth place. And this is Bob Brown, on his way to third place. The checkered flag for John Surtees, and he's scored his first TT double. His average speed is 98.63 miles per hour for the seven laps, and he's well on his way to another world championship.